All right, we're going to try this again here. I tell you, it's hard to record something with one hand. But what I have here is an experiment going on to make hydrogen gas to operate a couple of different things. My generator for my house current, should I need it, and also my Jeep. And so what I've built here is just an experiment trial here. Originally, I started off with a little three-plater, and built this one last night, a little 10-plate. Now, these are only like 2 inches by 3 inches long, each individual plate. And I've got two different power sources I'm testing here right now. I've got a 24-volt one over here. It's not plugged in the wall yet. And I have another one that is plugged in the wall that's laying on the floor here, which is an 18-volt at 2.5 amps. So I'm going to go ahead and plug this baby in. Okay, you can see the lights on. This is a little distribution box I built here. And you can see the production. All these little bubbles you see coming up is hydrogen. Every now and then you'll see a burst of a bigger bubble. And those are oxygen. So basically we're taking H2O, this is distilled water, with a tablespoon of baking soda. And this is what we're going to separate the gases and create the hydrogen. So now, once again, this is the 18-volt one, okay? Now, I'm going to go over here and disconnect it, all right, from the distribution box here. Now, it's starting to settle down, and then I'm going to plug the one here. Now, this is a 24-volt, 0.6 amp, all right? So, I'm going to go ahead and plug this one in, and you can see the production I get there, really doing good. 24 volts at 0.6 amps seems to be doing damn good. Okay, what I'm going to do now is come over here and I'm going to test, see what voltage I am getting there. Okay, you see I got my probe there. And here, I'm getting about 15 volts according to this. Nope, there we go, 19 volts. So I'm getting 19 volts off of this cell here, which isn't too bad. All right, so there's the hydrogen. You know, if you produce enough of this, it will run your car or truck or whatever, you know. It's just getting enough volume into the combustion chamber. But it's not much different than running LP. And I've already done the LP on my vehicles here in the past, and my generator. Just did the generator in the garage just recently, the LP. So this is going to take the place of LP. Water is a lot cheaper than LP is, so this is why my interest. And naturally, I'm going to go ahead and unplug this here. But you can see that thing's really coming off pretty darn good. Now I'm going to unplug it. Now she's stopping. All right. But this is my experiment. I'm probably about 3 weeks away of hooking anything up. I've got some pieces of parts ordered that I need to build my final one. And we'll be ready for the test on the generator first, and then we're going to move over to the car. All right. Just thought I'd share with you. Have a good day. All right. We have, I think, our final design that we're going to test on the generator here. I think you can probably see it. You got one cell here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There's actually 10 separate cells in here. And powered up. That's pretty darn good here. We're going to plug it up. Yeah, dropping things here. Bear with me here. Find the end of my cord here. Okay, here we have a little power supply here I built. Okay, and I'm going to plug this cord into it. Okay, and as I do, you can watch the response we get. Okay, ready, plug it in. All right. It goes pretty fast. It actually starts generating hydrogen almost instantly as I plug it in, and you can see that it's actually putting out some pretty good production here. I think this will work pretty good. I'm going to try it on the generator first and see if I have enough output. If not, I'll increase. I've got room for, oh geez, one, two, at least two more cells in there, maybe three. Yeah, one, two, three, yeah, maybe three cells I can put in there to increase it. But as you can see, we got a bunch of small little bubbles coming up, and that's the hydrogen. And you'll see some big bubbles popping up, and those are the oxygen. It's looking pretty darn good. I mean, it's really, really, really doing some bubbling here. All right, that's it. Today is the 21st of September. All right, what we got here is got the hydrogen cell I built in this sauce pan. We have a little energy or transfer box for the energy going into the hydrogen cells. And got a sealed lid. We've got a negative and a positive post coming out of it. Got a hose, which is collecting the hydrogen going into this water. And as you can see, what we are getting hydrogen. And this is going to be the fuel. Whether I have enough to run anything yet with is yet to be known. I'm going to add a couple more cells to it. Got room for actually probably three. Probably run three more cells into this little container. And then I'm going to hook it into my generator and see what happens. That would be the easiest thing to hook it into. So that's the goal plan. All right, here we are. As you can see, this is the hydrogen cell I built in this pan here, and got negative and positive coming off of it. I'm running on 18 volts at 4.5 amps. This is my distribution power distribution box going in. Got a positive negative feed into that. I'm collecting the hydrogen from this tube into this glass, and you can see these bubbles coming up, and that's hydrogen. Just to prove to you that this is hydrogen, I'm going to set it on fire. You'll hear it popping. There it goes again. There goes one pop. There goes another pop. Yep. Explode them, I should say. Keeps blowing this thing out of the problem. Oh, now we got our lid here again. Let's see if we can blow up some more. There we go. Did it again. Hydrogen. Very explosive. Works well. I'm Jerry Caldwell. Back at you again.